Hello everybody, welcome in this video lecture series on 8051 microcontroller. In today's video session, we are going to discuss an interrupt programming in 8051 microcontroller. So as we know, in case of 8051 microcontroller, we are there with some different internal features like some register, RAM, ROM, this timer section, followed with serial communication, input output port to fulfill the clock requirement, oscillator circuitry to have the control over the bus control section, this central processing unit, and along with that, one of the most important, that is an interrupt control unit. So this interrupt control unit is going to control the interrupt activity associated with 8051 microcontroller, which may be deals with say external hardware with timer and this serial communication. So let us begin. So first of all, what is an interrupt? So as its name suggests, an interrupt is an external or internal event that interrupts the microcontroller to inform that a device needs a service. Let us consider simple one call waiting feature which is present in our mobile communication on our cell phone. Suppose right now person A is communicating with person B. So the faithful communication is going on. So I will consider this as simple my main task. Person A is communicating with person B, so this is the main task right now executing. So meanwhile, what is happened? The person C trying to call person A. Just try to get this. The person A is communicating with person B. This I am going to consider as a main task. And meanwhile, the person C tried to call to person A. So whenever the person C is going to call person A and the call is under process with person B, then what is happening? We are getting some notification on the mobile phone. The person A is going to get some notification in the form of, I will say, simple beeps during the ongoing call with the B. So whatever this notification that generated, what it indicate? It indicate that the person C want to communicate with person A. So I will say this as my subroutine. So now it's totally choice of person A whether to continue the call with person B or just keep the call with person B on hold and communicate with person C. If suppose person A is going to hold a call with person B and he is going to communicate with person C, then what is happening in this case? Here the main task, that is the call with B, is under ongoing call, and meanwhile the person C is calling. So the moment at which person C is calling, the A is going to keep the call on hold and he is going to continue with person C. So here this is call by A with B, then he is going to keep the call on hold and now it is communicating with C. And once it completes the call with the C, then what will happen? He is again going to retrieve a call which was there with B on hold and continue this execution. This is with whom? This is with simple person B. So here what it represents, this specific activity represents what? The execution of interrupt, as well as after generation of interrupt, the routine is get executed and that is called as an interrupt service routine. So ISR, So here the call with person C is get executed only when this notification is accepted by person A. So this notification I will say as what? Simple my interrupt signal. So here once the A is going to receive this B, that is a notification, he is going to keep the call with person B on hold and going to continue with person C. So here this is my main task or the main routine, and here I will say this is a interrupt service routine because he is going to call with person C only when he is going to receive a notification about this call waiting. So this in short represents what? The way in which the interrupt is executed. So in short, in microcontroller, what is there? In embedded system, rather I can say, suppose The central processing unit is executing one task. This task, we will say, has what symbol? My main task, right? And another one routine is there with me, right? So this routine I will say as simple subroutine. Okay, so here when this CPU is continuing with main task, and suppose the subroutine wants the execution from microcontroller, this subroutine is going to generate one signal to inform that he want the execution, and this notification or this signal is basically called as a interrupt signal, right? Why it is called as an interrupt? Because right now the CPU is busy with main task, but here the interruption is done. Okay, this subroutine is requesting continuously that I want the execution, I want the execution. So he is trying to interrupt this execution, right? And once, so now it's totally depend on the CPU whether to continue with main task or to go to the subroutine. If he is going to accept this, what we call the interrupt, right? He is going to accept the interrupt, then this is called as what? Simple accepting this interrupt signal. Okay, so here the CPU is going to continue then with the subroutine, completes this subroutine, and again it will come back to this main routine. Okay, so here if the call is accepted or the signal is accepted, then it is called as a unmaskable. You can't ignore this, right? And if this notification or this interrupt is accepted, it is rejected, or then it is called as a maskable, right? So it's totally depend. Either the CPU can accept this call or accept or pay attention towards this interrupt and just execute this subroutine, or he is going to totally ignore it. If the CPU is going to ignore this interrupt, then that interrupt is said to be like a maskable. And if the CPU is not going to ignore this, going to pay attention towards the interrupt, then it is called as a unmaskable. So simple. The CPU is dealing with one task. When the another task wants the execution, that task 2, I will re-repeat it again. Consider the CPU is dealing with task 1, right? And meanwhile, another one task is there with me, and that task I will say as a task 2. And if the task 2 wants the execution, right, what the task 2 is going to do? The task 2 is going to generate one special signal to inform that the task 2 wants this execution. And this concept is basically called as an interrupt. So right now, suppose my CPU is dealing with task 1, he is executing this task 1 up to say this point. When he completes this when this interrupt is generated, it holds this task 1, the CPU is going to hold the task 1, paying attention toward task 2, complete entire this task 2, and again come back to a point from where he has holded the task 1 here, and then it still continues here. So this entire activity represents what? The overview of an interrupt, right? So what is that? This concept is called as an interrupt, right? And this task 2, which is get executed only after say generation of this interrupt, and that's why, right, this task is called as a interrupt service routine, that is a ISR, interrupt service routine. Okay, so this is about an overview of what simple your interrupt, right? So again, now consider one simple situation. Right now I'm there with this microcontroller, and this microcontroller is dealing with different devices, say device number 1, device number 2, and device number 3. There are two ways, right, by which the microcontroller can communicate with these three devices. The one technique is called as a polling technique, right? So now I am going to represent that with this red color, okay? And the second technique is called as an interrupt technique. Right now we had discussed about this interrupt, the overview of interrupt. Now let us find out what is the difference between simple your polling technique and an interrupt technique, right? So what situation we are considering here? Right now the microcontroller has connected with three different devices, device number 1, device number 2, and device number 3. So this microcontroller can communicate with device D1, D2, and D3 by two ways, either by polling technique or by interrupt technique. Now let us find out what is polling. Polling means what? The CPU is continuously monitors the status of given devices. Okay. The microcontroller continuously checks the status of device number 1, device number 2, and device number 3 sequentially. I can say this is the most important one, the order in which the programming is done, right? So in that order it is paying attention towards these three devices, or I can say these three tasks here. When the condition is met, it performs the service. For example, now the device number one is this microcontroller is communicating with device number one, right? So it is going to communicate with device number one. When the specific condition is met, then he is going to entertain this device number one, right? Then after that, it moves to monitor the next device until one served, right? So my diagram will be like this now, right? So the scene is simple. So let us consider, instead of device number one, device number two, or device number three, I will say the execution here. Okay, so that is what T1. Let us consider the three different tasks are there instead of devices T1, T2, and T3. So first, the microcontroller is going to deal with task number one. When the specific condition is met in task number one, he will complete the task number one and switch towards the task number. When this condition is also met, then he is going to deal with the task number three, right? And after completing all these three, again it will come to this maybe for the task number one. In this way, sequentially, right? So this condition means what? As like say, consider the status of TF1 flag, right? So how we did? We initially, when the rollover not occurred, then the TF1 status was zero. Once the rollover occurs, status is going to change from 0 to 1. So we are generally mentioned this JNB TF0, comma here, and again what here. Suppose this is my task number 1. So this the CPU is continuously dealing with the status of this TF1, and until the TF1 is 0, it will wait for the same instruction. It is not going to execute the next instruction. So I will consider, suppose this is my task number 1. So unless and until the status is going to change from 0 to 1, he is not going to move to task number 2, right? So this is what one kind of operation that done in a polling. So what is that? The polling can monitor the status of several devices and serve each of these devices when the certain condition is met, right? So now what is the drawback of it? In the polling method, it is not efficient because it wastes much more time of microcontroller even though for a devices which do not need a service, right? Sequentially, just go with T1. After T1, it is switching towards T2. After T2, it is switching towards T3. Suppose right now the T2 is not required any what we call the attention or the service, but still he is going to deal with this T2 itself because of what the sequential executions here, right? So exactly opposite of it, we are there with what? Simple, this interrupt architecture. Now, what is the basic difference between interrupt architecture and polling? One of the most important one, as said, whenever any device needs its service, the device notifies the microcontroller by sending a signal, which is known as an interrupt signal, the most important one, right? Here it is going to make use of what? Simple, your interrupt activity. Means what? Again, consider the same situation. The microcontroller, task number 1, task number 2, and task number 3, these three are there. In polling, what is done? The microcontroller first going to communicate simple with task 1, after completion of the execution with task 2, sequentially dealing with task 3, and after that task 1, task 2, and task 3, sequentially it is dealing with all these activities. But right now, suppose some emergency is there for this task 3, okay, and the microcontroller is dealing with task 1, right? The task T3 has to wait until the CPU is going to switch towards task number 2 and again going for this. Means this much amount of waiting period, means the time taken by T2, this much amount of waiting period for what? The T3 to be get executed. But it is not true in case of interrupt. In interrupt, how the things are going to work? Say the microcontroller is there with me, the T1 is there with me, T2 and T3, right? So here the sequential execution is not there, right? Whenever any task generates or wants some execution, what the task will do? The task will directly generate a signal, and this signal is basically called as what? An interrupt signal, right? So the microcontroller is waiting for the signals to be received from T1, T2, T3, right? So once the T1 is going to generate the signal, directly it is providing a service to T1, right? Suppose right now the T3 is going to generate a signal. So what the microcontroller will do? It will finish the execution with T1 and directly switch towards the T3. But this is not true in case of polling. In polling, what is happening? First is dealing with T1, after that go with T2, and then just serve to T3. But here, the task which needs the service, directly that going to generate a signal, with that signal is known as what? Simple, our interrupt signal, right? And after reception of interrupt signal from specific, what we call that the task, right? The execution is provided, right? So in this way, simple this interrupt and polling techniques are going to use. So as said, upon receiving this interrupt signal, the microcontroller interrupts whatever it is doing and service the device, right? So the program which is associated with an interrupt is called as a interrupt service routine. Okay, so this is nothing but what your IS, right? So now, for every interrupt, there must be an interrupt service routine for interrupt or interrupt handler, right? So it is also called as what, the interrupt service routine. When an interrupt is evoked, that means when the interrupt is generated, the microcontroller runs this interrupt service routine. Okay, for every interrupt, there is a fixed location in it that puts the address of ISR. Okay, and the group of memory location set aside to hold the address of ISR, and that is called as what, simple, the interrupt vector table. Okay, so we are going to discuss that right now. Okay, so simple, what it indicates, this slide, what this slide specifically explains, recall the discussion that we had in a first, what we call the slide. Consider the microcontroller is dealing with task number one, right, and another is one there, that is what, my task number two, right? So here the microcontroller first executing the task number one, so that's why we will say this as what, my main task. Okay, so when the task number two wants the execution, what it will do, it will generate one special signal. This signal we are going to say as what, an interrupt signal. So what the CPU do, it is going to hold the status associated with task number one, then switch towards this task number two, complete entire this task number two, and again come back to this task number one and continue with the execution with task number one here, right? So here the T2 is get executed only when, okay, which is also known as what, the interrupt handler, right? And associated with this is, means what, the program which are to be get executed only after generation of interrupt, that are called as a interrupt service routine, and each of this program is having some certain memory locations. Generally called as what, simple, this interrupt service routine. Okay, so let us discuss it in detail. So upon activation of this interrupt, what exact task are done, right? The microcontroller goes through following steps. What is the first step? It finishes the execution. So upon activation of this interrupt, what exact task are done, right? The microcontroller goes through following steps. What is the first step? It finishes the execution, finishes the instruction which is it executing, right? So as we know that in case of embedded system, the basic three stages are there associated with an instructions. The first one is a fetch, the second one is a decode, and the third one is what, simple, the execution, or I will say as a execute, right? So let us consider I am there with 3-4 instruction, my first number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4 and number 5. Number 1 instruction, number 2, number 3, number 4 and number 5, and here I am there with this interrupt. So let us find out what activities that occur upon activation of an interrupt signal, right? So simple, here after activation of interrupt signal, the first, the microcontroller finishes the instruction that it is executing, right? After that, it saves the address of next location, that is the next instruction, onto the stack, and we know that the program counter always point out next instruction which is to be get executed next. Then it jump to fixed location in a memory called as a interrupt vector table that holds the address of ISR, execute this ISR and come back to the place where it was interrupted and continues the execution. For example, let us consider this, right now I am there with this task number one. Okay, so consider that right now I am dealing with the task number one. In task number 1, my first instruction is there at instruction, say memory location C300, first instruction, C301, say instruction number 2, C302 at instruction number 3, C303 at instruction, this is instruction number 4, and C304 dealing with an instruction number 5, right? And now suppose my task 2 is there with me, that is the second task, that is the sub, and it holds the address, suppose C400, C401, then C402, and then C403, like this. Okay, so what it will do, right? Suppose right here the CPU is executing a second number instruction which is present at memory location C301. So the moment at which the interrupt is generated from task number 2,
The next instruction, what is that? C302. It stores this address, C302, at the stack. The next memory location's address, that is C302, is so stored onto the stack, and then the CPU or the execution is jumped to an memory location, this C400. Because just try to get this. The instruction which is present at C301, that is my instruction number 2, right now the CPU is executing and this interrupt signal is generated, right? So what it does, it finished this instruction number 2, right? This is what my first step. Then it saves the address of next instruction. That means my next instruction, instruction number 3, is present at C302. So this address it is going to store onto the stack, right? Then it jumped to the fixed location. Okay, so suppose the task number 2 is stored at memory location C400 and it is stored at somewhere else, and that somewhere else is nothing but a vector table, right? So it get this address, the CPU, this program counter gets this address, means it is jumped to this task number 2, right? It execute this entire task number 2, which is nothing but what, the interrupt service routine. And after completion of this, whatever the address is there, this address is retrieved, and the microcontroller or the CPU execution come back to instruction number 3, which is present at C302, and it continues the execution of this main task. So in this way, simple, the interrupt works in 8051 microcontroller. Okay, now what is this in case of 8051 microcontroller? Total 6 different interrupt sources are present, right? So this concept basically called as what, the interrupt vector table, right? So which are the 6 interrupt sources? The first one is a reset, the second one is the external Halvin interrupt 0, which is generated through port pin P3.2, generally known as INT 0 bar. Then next one is timer 0. The next interrupt is a external hardware interrupt 1, then timer 1, and for the serial communication. In short, out of these 6 interrupts, right, the one interrupt is associated with reset, the 2 interrupts are associated with the timer block, 2 interrupts are associated with an external environment, that generally said as a hardware interrupt, and for serial communication we are there with a single interrupt, right? So this is what, these are the different 6 interrupt sources. One is with reset, 2 are there with simple hardware, which are generally known as a hardware interrupt, right? INT 0 bar, INT 1 bar. The 2 interrupts are associated with an timer, that is with timer 0 and with timer 1, and one interrupt is simply associated with what, the serial communication. And here this is the vector table. This vector table, what this vector table indicates, for example, right now consider here, we are there with this different location. The one location is a 0000H. Okay, here I am going to write some code at location suppose C0003. Here we are writing some code. The next location is suppose 0000B. Here is some code we are going to write. Then the one more 00. And at last 0023. These are the different location, and at this fixed location we are writing some code here, right? So I will say, or I am writing some program. This is my I will say this is my code 1, this is the code 2, this is the code 3, code 4, code 5, and code 6. Now what this interrupt vector table indicates, right? So the interrupt vector table holds some address, and which are this address, right? Okay, let us find out that. And now I am there with the CPU is dealing with the task 1, that is the main task, I will say, okay, or the main program it is executing. And right now during the execution, suppose, okay, consider we are going to reset the device. During execution I am going to reset the device, means what, I am now dealing with pin number 9. I am going to send one high to low signal for minimum 2 machine cycle on this pin number 9. So what will happen, the moment at which I am going to reset my device, the program counter directly jumped to this fixed memory location, that is what, C0000H. And whatever code that return from memory location 4 zeros, like, that means what, 0000, that code is getting executed. Or let us consider, right now the CPU is dealing with task number 1, and during execution of this task number 2, suppose the timer 0 interrupt is generated, right? So the moment at which timer 0 interrupt is generated, what is the say the vector address for it? 000B. Means the moment at which timer 0 interrupt is generated, right? So directly the CPU is going to jump to this fixed memory location, and it is automatically executes the code which is present at memory location 000B, that is code C3. Just try to get this. This concept is called as what? The interrupt vector table and execution of ISR. C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, all are ISR, that is interrupt service routine. All are get executed only when a specific interrupt is generated. So when the timer 0 interrupt generated, the location which is present, or the code which is present at location 000B, that is this, that get executed. When the hardware interrupt 1 is generated, then corresponding to hardware interrupt 1, we are there with memory location 0013, right? So what will happen? The moment at which this hardware interrupt 1 is generated, right? So CPU directly jump to this memory location and code C3 is get executed. So here these addresses are nothing but simple vector, I will say, right? So this defines the memory location where to jump. Once the interrupt is generated, which code to be get executed, right? So what I want to do, I want to say execute code C5, C6 only when this serial communication interrupt is generated. And then what I'm supposed to do, I'm going to write the code or the task that I want to do after generation of serial communication interrupt at memory location 0023, right? So in this way, this interrupts operate in case of 8051 microcontroller. And these are the priority level. The top priority is given to reset, then hardware interrupt 0, then timer 0, hardware interrupt 1, then timer 1 and serial communication. For example, let us recall this same, right? So as we know that right now in case of 8051 microcontroller, the 6 different interrupts are there with me, right? So when the first reset interrupt is generated, then the code which is written at fixed memory location 0000 executed. Right, so what the this priority indicate right now, when this reset interrupt is generated, then the code whatever written at memory location this 0000H, that get executed. When the timer 1 interrupt is generated, then the code written at 000001B, that is get executed. But now let us consider simultaneously two interrupts are generated. The one interrupt is timer 0 interrupt and the second interrupt is what? Serial communication interrupt. Then what will happen in this case? First, the CPU is going to, as the timer 0 interrupt is having the higher priority as compared to what your serial communication interrupt. So what the CPU does, right? Simple, it is first going to execute the interrupt service routine which is written at memory location 000B, and then it is going to pay attention towards 0023, because here the serial communication is with the lowest priority. Right now suppose the timer 0 interrupt is there, and after that timer 0 interrupt, suppose along with the timer 0 interrupt, this hardware interrupt 0 is generated. Then what will happen? The CPU first execute the 0003 and then it is switching towards this 000B, right? So this is again what totally depends on what simple your priority. So in this way, the interrupt architecture or structure is present in case of 8051 microcontroller. Total 6 interrupt sources are present. The first one is a reset. The two are associated with the external hardware interrupt, two are associated with the timer, and one is there with the serial communication. And the priority is as like this. The top priority is given to reset, then to hardware interrupt 0, then for timer 0, then hardware interrupt 1, then timer 1, and at last serial communication. So in the next sessions, we are going to discuss the SFRs associated with these interrupts. Thank you.